Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to From the Depths. I'm Sam, and today I've got something really exciting for you. This monstrosity here, a mass driver, and it's currently pointing at a crucible. The crucible is a Scarlet Dawn godly craft and costs about 2 million resources. Our little mass driver here, 100,000 including the ammo. What is it? How does it work? I'll explain later. First, let me show you. If I press the firing key here, then a projectile flies into the distance. And if we look on the top right, we see that we just did 3 million damage and apparently hit something explosive, maybe a cannon, maybe the engine, because the damage numbers are still ticking. Now that the nuclear mushroom clears, we can see the destruction and we can see a pretty massive hole in the ship. Okay, let's reload another projectile and fire again. And again, we're looking at over 3 million damage. And the crucible is falling out of the sky. And yep, look at it, raining shells, beautiful. And the crucible is dead in just 2 shots. What is it? How does it work? It's a mass driver, and it's, in my opinion, probably the most powerful, most effective weapon in the game. It uses a few exploits, which I will go through and explain. The idea behind it is basically the same as ICBMs, where ICBMs, compared to missiles, you see before we had large and huge missiles. If we wanted a big missile, we had to build one ourselves and basically just build a craft that had nukes on it and flew into the enemy. This thing is trying to do to cannons what ICBMs do to missiles. So basically build a huge thing that just goes off the charts with the numbers it can achieve. So this is our cannon. It provides the propulsion, and this is our projectile, which flies into the enemy with some nukes. How does it work? The magic is right here in the projectile. It has a few railgun casings for the energy and graviton ram. This is the magic thing. The shell will exert a force equal to its unmitigated recoil on the vehicle it hits. Slightly reduces kinetic damage, but that's not important. I have an EMP head, but that's just so that I don't damage the projectile itself. It's not that important. Okay, so what does it do? Well, right here we have 4 cannons. Pretty big railguns, shooting at 550,000 energy capacity each. And they fire this ramming shell at these projectiles. We can reload one right now real quick. There you go. And they hit these truss blocks here, which then propels, because the impact propels the projectile forward. They shoot the projectile forward at these projectiles. I think fly at roughly 2 kilometers per second. That would be Mach 7, 8 off the top of my head. It's pretty hard to do commentary and do math at the same time, sorry, but roughly that's extremely fast. It would be like 6,000 kilometers per second, I think. Yeah. Not quite orbital speed, but we're getting close. Where was I? Lost track of things. Yeah, das kann ich ausschneiden. We can go into the projectile real quick, and if we fire right now, there you can see we're flying at 2000 meters per second. Also, you could see for a second there, it was like spreading those arms out with the spin box here. That's to spread out the nukes a bit, so we can get our damage on a bit, so we can spread out the nukes a bit and thus spread out the damage. But I will go into the projectiles in another video. Because it's pretty complex, and this thing is still in the prototype stage, and I'm constantly improving the projectiles, and those are not the final finished product, I think. But yeah, like I said, we'll go into that later. For now, I will show you how to build one real quick. They are actually pretty simple. Two, maybe more. 500 millimeter railguns. I mean, you, I guess you could make it out of a gunpowder system, but if you're afraid of big numbers, then you probably shouldn't be here. I mean, this thing is ridiculous anyway, so there's really no point in going around and saving money. I won't go and build an effective one, it's just for the principle, basically. There we go, that's pretty much it. Now we know we need a docking station. We need to set up the railguns real quick to just use all of the energy that it can give us. There we go. Build a new vehicle. This will be our projectile. We'll just make it a lead beam for now. There we go. Looks kind of phallic. Now it looks too religious. What can we use? Is this better? No. Whatever. It will have to do. Selection, get it in a bit closer, and there you go. Okay, so now we just have to rig some advanced control blocks so that at the same time the docking station releases the projectile and the guns fire, so that the projectile is in free fall and can be pushed away in the same moment that it fires. Otherwise, what would happen is basically you. If I line this up a bit real quick, fire the projectile, but it just gets dragged back immediately, and I just set off the nuke. Yeah, whatever. I'll repair it later, don't worry. Okay, so we now need control, advanced control blocks, set up two, set the advanced dim trigger to whatever key you want, or an external input if you want. Then we need docking stations, release all assigned vehicles, and here we need weapon systems. Where is it? I'm being blind again. Ugh, I'm in the wrong tab. That's why I couldn't find it. Fire, and also reduce the range a bit, because we don't want to set everything off. By the way, if you have two advanced control blocks sitting next to each other, and only one of them has an input, but both of them have an output, then it will getting that input will trigger both of them. You can see here, if U is pressed, will release all assigned vehicles and fire weapons. Works the same way in the other way, by the way. If you have inputs on both control blocks, but an output only on one of them, then you will need to activate both control blocks in order to get the output to work. For example, only when on a timer plus an external input, or only when at a certain altitude and pitch or whatever. Yeah, so now if we press the U key, it should fire the guns and release the projectile at the same time, and boom, there you go. We reached almost 3000 meters per second for a moment there. Obviously, as soon as we hit the water, drag gets pretty bad. How far out are we? Almost half of a grid square. That's actually pretty good. Yeah, and that's all there is to it, by the way. Basically, build it on a turret so you can aim it. I have a rudimentary reload system here, but I will go into more detail on that on a later video. And yeah, now you can shoot the enemy with your ridiculous projectiles. Let me restart the designer real quick to repair everything and get the projectiles back. In theory, it would be better to use not the docking station because they wobble too much, but instead use the vehicle blueprint spawner, because there you can set a hold time and they will hold it fixed. But I'll have to look into that a bit later. Yeah, the next videos will be about projectile designs, because as you can see, the projectiles right now are pretty crazy. You can have different variations, like these ones have nukes, they have zero drag, which is an exploit, another exploit. I found, basically, if we go here and fire it, you can see that our speed is staying constant at 2013 meters per second. Okay, now it's 100 because I automatically recall the projectiles in case they miss. But we don't suffer from drag, even if we go underwater. Yeah, you have these arms spitting off and everything, so there's a lot of thought going into the projectile design, I think even more than into the cannon. For instance, I managed, at the beginning my projectile was just a solid lead block, and it was hitting the target for, I think, 300k damage. And right now this design does over 1 million pure kinetic damage plus another million explosive damage, even though I'm using less than half of the railgun power and scaled down the railgun a bit a lot. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like I said, next video about the projectile. After that I will go into optimization to build this one so it reloads automatically and you don't have to press anything like I do. And then where I squeeze it into this thing, which is a platform I'm using, which looks pretty amazing in my opinion. It has like a recoil system that whenever you fire your gun it recoils back, and whatever little shenanigans. Yeah, that's about it. Let's spawn in another crucible for fun and watch the world burn, I guess. Can go into the projectile. Yeah, didn't last very long. It also can fire very quickly. Like what's limiting here is basically the recharge rate of the ray guns. But I guess you could fire like potentially up to once every second or every 2 seconds or something. Right now we're getting a bit unlucky, the projectiles are a bit unreliable and we don't always get the maximum energy into the projectiles. Sometimes I think the bullets from the guns fly through the truss blocks. Yeah, stop playing around, Sam. Stop wasting time. Okay, thanks for watching, like I said. And goodbye.